In today's video, we look at the thermal insulation of a heated bed of our 3D printer. We will talk about if it makes sense to buy one and show you its advantages and disadvantages. That being said, the core of the entire video will be this adhesive insulation under the heated bed. It consists of a thin layer of aluminium foil glued on top of a layer of polyurethane foam. Aluminium foil can reflect heat very effectively. For us, this should mean that the heating bed will heat up faster and retain its heat longer. But is that true? This insulation can be purchased in various sizes and thicknesses. For the Creality Ender 3D printer and similar, the most suitable size is 235 to 235 mm. For this video, I only tested the 7 mm thick version. You can buy this insulation, for example, on the popular AliExpress. Before we dive into installing this insulation, let's take some measurements. After all, we want to show some cool graphs at the end and pat ourselves on the back for how much we can now save time and money during the printing process. First, I measured how fast the heated bed could heat up from 25 degrees to 60 degrees and how much electricity it consumed. Then, what will be the power consumption for 30 and 60 minutes while trying to keep the heated bed at that temperature. And lastly, how long will it take the heated bed to drop from the measured temperature to 30 degrees? I used 30 degrees because that's the temperature at which a lot of adhesion enhancers lose their superpowers. I ran the same test with temperatures of 70, 80 and 110 degrees. All this first without insulation and then with insulation. After the measurements were completed, I glued the insulation to the heated bed. Basically, all I had to do was remove the heated bed from the y-axis, lay the heated bed on the insulation and mark where the screw holes are located. At these points, we need to make holes for the springs or whatever we use instead. For example, I use these silicone mounts, as you know from previous videos. The temperature of the heated bed and the pressure of these silicone mounts on the insulation could cause it to peel and deform. Don't ask me how I know. I will just add that you need to heat the heated bed above 100 degrees to peel off the damaged insulation. Don't try to take it off when it's cold. When hot, the insulation can be taken off without damage. The remaining adhesive can be removed with denatured alcohol or isopropyl alcohol. After installing the insulation and returning the heated bed back to the printer, it was time to repeat the previous tests. After the measurements were finished, all I had to do was write everything down in the graphs and voila! The heating time of the print bed has not changed significantly. The biggest difference was at 110 degrees. The same applies to the power consumption during heating. In the test of keeping the temperature of the heated bed for 30 minutes, a progressively greater reduction in power consumption can be seen. The same is valid for the test of keeping the temperature for 60 minutes. Now imagine what the savings must be for a 10-hour print run, for example. For the time it takes for the heated bed to cool down to 30 degrees, you can see that it was now necessary to wait a little longer again. All these measurements were performed on the same printer and without calibrating the heating parameters of the heated bed. This calibration could further optimize the heating speed of the heated bed and the subsequent power consumption during printing. Obviously, on your printer and under different weather conditions, you will get different numbers and measure different consumption. At lower temperatures, the numbers are not significantly higher. In fact, they are as small as, for example, the number of subscribers currently watching my videos. So click on the subscribe button and the bell to make sure you don't miss anything. But back to the video. As you can see from the graphs, there is an improvement. In the case of higher temperatures, it is even more noticeable. Therefore, I take this Trema insulation as useful and will be happy to recommend it as another upgrade to your 3D printer.